A big hello and a warm welcome to all of you amazing and beautiful people out there. Welcome to my channel. This channel is only for people who are focused on source integration and they have found some kind of deep love that they never experienced before after they started doing inner work, and after they surrendered fully, they realize that they have started touching onto something which is unique, which is amazing, and which gives them a lot of confidence, which gives them a lot of hope, faith, and they are getting connected to their higher self through this source integration. And what they are going through in this particular session, this is a bunch of people, this is a collective reading. So a lot of these people who are currently getting into source integration, these are very, 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 I would say very blessed and very lucky people. Very lucky souls actually, and they've gone through a lot in their life. They have suffered a lot. They have suffered through all types of problems that you can imagine, all types of issues. They have gone through financial problems. They have gone through neglect. They have gone through backstabbing. They've gone through betrayal. They have, you know, anybody they look to for peace and for happiness, for joy, they never got it. Okay. And slowly and gradually, after being in a very miserable condition, very miserable situation, they could have even gone to a lot of, you know, psychiatrists, or they could have gone to some doctors, or they could have gone to some mind coaches, some mental coaches, or this and that, some astrologers, but they never met anyone who is genuine. Anybody they met, everybody was not genuine. They were either selfish, or they were genuine, or they were not clearly communicating. They were not saying, okay, this is what I'm doing with you. Okay. They could have gone for some past life regression therapy. They could have gone for some, I don't know, different classes. So after trying out many things, they realized that this is really not working for me. None of this is working for me. And obviously there is a sense of suffering. There is a sense of pain. There is a sense of loss. So when this happens, they surrender, okay? But for a lot of people, surrender could have happened after, you know, they want something, they want to manifest something, and that desire frustrated them a lot and they waited for it for a long time. Maybe somebody wrote to me on the channel Twin Flame Union that they have been waiting for contact for 30 years. I don't think so. I can wait for 30 years for a contact. I'm sorry. But I was quite shocked with that person's patience and perseverance just to get a contact from someone. They have waited for 30 years. Like, till how long can they wait? For how long can they wait? How long can they be in the waiting energies? That was my question. I have not replied to that person, but I'm just saying I was very shocked with that comment, okay? But it's not very shocking also, because I know people who are doing inner work for 10 years, 15 years, 20 years also. However, the inner work that they are doing is not correct inner work. Okay. And this is the primary reason why I decided to make this type of content on YouTube. I have actually been experiencing this since a long time. The first time I channeled this content was into a book called In the Name of Love, A Journey of Finding Your Ultimate Soulmate. I figured out that, you know, the love that you're looking outside, that's really not outside. There's no one outside who can love you. Trust me on that. And this is from my personal experience, I'm saying this. And guys and girls, I've been in this journey since my childhood, since the day I was like a really young child, and I was very much frustrated with this human society, with the flawed human society, with the abuse, sexual abuse, the bullying, the pressure that they put on to you to get the grades, to get the marks, or the selfishness they show, you know, all of that. And this is the time when I met my master, and my master came across to me as the most unconditional, selfless person that I ever met. And as I started growing into this journey, I realized that some of my animal friends are also very unconditional. They are not like the selfish human beings. But they also started coming into my life closer and closer as I was more and more miserable and frustrated. So I understand a lot of you have actually come in contact with the source after getting totally frustrated with the people around you.
And then, it's not like you are perfect and you don't have any flaws and you don't have any problems, because the darkness that you see outside of you, the darkness is also within you. It's inside of you, right? But how does it go inside of you? That's the thing that you need to figure out. How does this programming impact people so much, and why is this programming there in the first place? Why is this planet so miserable? Why is the third dimension... Till the third dimension, they are miserable. After the fourth dimension, things are better, things are easier. So now this person, this collective group of seekers who are in the surrender process, and they are experiencing amazing relief. It's like somebody has applied medicine. It's like you have a really bad headache and somebody gives you some medicine and it heals in like no time. And you're like, wow, how did this happen? And this... I'm telling you again from my own experience, and I don't know who all are here. All of you who resonate with it, please let me know. I would be very happy to see a comment about your experience, okay? So, if you, and we don't know how many people are there on this planet who's doing this type of work, because we are in the stage of transition right now, and we have stepped out from the dark ages, and we are 20 years into the age of energy. Actually, the dark ages end at 1900. So from that perspective, we are 120 years into the age of energy, which is a really good thing. And this year, this 2020 has brought many things into perspective. And I don't know for how many times I'm going to say this, but I think I need to keep saying it till I have to say it, till it's resonating or till it's being channeled like that. But 2020 is a very, very important year, because some of the people who are experiencing the source integration right now, they did not start experiencing it 2020. They started experiencing some changes right from 2015, 2014, 2015. They started getting into some kind of perception. Their point of view had changed. They were not very happy with many things. They were saying no to many things. 2016 must have been an important year. 2017 was another important year. 2018 onwards, they got more betrayed, they got more cheated on, they probably fell in love with some people who put them into a very dark or a very deep runner-chaser dynamic, which was one of the final runner-chaser dynamic phases, and then, there was a dark night of the soul. But 2018, they started coping up well with the dark nights, and 2019, the subtle dark nights were there, and 2020 was a boom, like a big bang, But they could relate with it because they were fed up. By 2020, they were fed up. They were fed up. They may have cursed a lot of humans. Like, they may have just cursed the human society. Like, you humans, you deserve this or you deserve that. And suddenly 2020 happened and they were like, oh my God, what's happening? What's happening? Like, seriously, what's happening? Now, anyway, the emotion is that the people in source integration are feeling this for the source, that you are the one who gives peace and love to my soul. You are the only one. The masters, and it's like the masters are there, the spirit guides are there, because they are connecting with the higher dimensions now, or they are connecting with maybe some teacher or maybe some coach or maybe somebody who's also in the higher dimension. They're living in the higher dimension. They're getting some kind of information. They're getting, I don't want to sound like my content is the best content, but you could say that maybe this channeling is also a part of it. Not to say that it's the best or it's the worst, but just to say that this is a message. This is a message for all the people that you are indeed experiencing the source integration right now. And you feel that you are going through some kind of a peace and love. And just in case, I'm not saying it's happening to all the people, but just in case, some of your old, very old exes have come back to you, or some, family members have started listening to you who never listened to you, by the way. Or, you've just started creating more peace around you. You've started, not only you have forgiven people who have hurt you, but you've also started helping other people, release their anger and frustration. Or as I said, that you're just listening to some content which is very, giving you a lot of epiphanies and a lot of joy, and you're like, yeah. I'm in a certain part of a community right now, or I'm doing something for the planet. I'm a contributor. So in some way or the other, you're getting this love and you feel very peaceful. It's literally like you're always high, but you don't even try. Or you're I'm not saying you're always high. Maybe you're getting into the zone of being always high. So it's literally like, I'm always high and I don't even try. 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 So you don't need any drugs. You don't need any alcohol. You don't need any junk food. You don't need. You look at food like it's just food. I just need to eat food for energy. You're not addicted to the food. You no longer look at food like I want to eat this. If I don't eat this, I'm going to be like, oh, I'm craving for this. I'm craving for that. You, even if you crave for something, you want something, you need something. The masters are giving it to you. You need a bit of money. Masters give it to you. You want to get into some therapy. Masters are helping you out with it. You want to help an animal. Masters are helping out you with it. You know, whatever you think, whenever you cry, like really cry so much and you're like going, oh, I'm so sad. I am so sad. Please help me out. In 15 minutes, in 20 minutes, sometimes 1 hour, maybe on the same day, something happens. And you also feel crazily that one day is full of adventures. Like one day, literally one day is full of adventure. Every day is like that. You wake up in the morning and you go to bed. And you know that in one day so much has happened. So you're like literally thinking, what have I touched? What have I gotten into? You know, what am I doing? And you don't have the doership. You don't feel like being the doer. You don't feel like being the doer. You don't feel like pretending. You can't fake. You can't, you know, please people, or neither do you expect the world to please you. You can handle criticism better. Like, you can get angry in a minute, you can forgive in a minute, you can cry in a minute, you can laugh in a minute, you can love with no expectations. Like, it's different, you know you're different, you're not the same person, but you know one thing for sure, that this energy is not coming from the worldly world. No, this is not coming from the worldly world. This is coming from you, Source. This is coming from you, Masters. This is coming from you, my spirit guides. These, you people are doing this. You people are doing this. And I'm so thankful to you. And I love you. And I love you. And you love me. And you love me unconditionally. Nobody has ever made me feel the way you make me feel. So protected, so guided. And I've made so many mistakes. I have made like so many mistakes. I am full of mistakes. You know, I've made so many mistakes and you have forgiven me for every single sin and every single mistake that I made. You don't judge me. You don't judge me ever, even if I've done the craziest thing. And even if I did not listen to you, maybe one of your masters or maybe somebody, you know, told you, you in your childhood or when you're growing up, that don't do this, don't do that. And you didn't listen to them. And now you feel like I didn't even listen to you, but you never let me go. You were always there for me. I was the one who went away from you. But you were always there for me. So you give me the peace. You give the love to my soul. You are my happiness. You are my life. You are everything for me. This is what you feel, okay? And you feel like you always felt that you were a blind person on planet Earth. You know, you were literally blind. And I don't want to again talk about myself, my friends, but I have actually experienced going blind when I was a child. So my third eye got blocked when I was 3 years old, and for some time I went completely blind and I was screaming and shouting and I created a huge ruckus. So I actually physically experienced being blind. But I know, and I'm sure you know, that the experience of your pineal gland clearing or your third eye clearing is more heartfelt. You understand that, you know, like you can sense vibrations, you can sense emotions, you can sense love. So you are literally telling universe, you're telling masters, you're telling source that you have settled in my heart chakra through my pineal gland. This experience, you know, the intuition. There are some people who get blocked completely, but their third eye never gets blocked. Their intuition power never goes away, you know. And they've done all sorts of things. They've had a lot of alcohol. They've, you know, taken a lot of drugs. They've taken a lot of non-vegetarian food, a lot of dead meat inside their body, traumatic meat, like bad food and everything bad, you know, like, and a lot of negative energy, negative frequency. They had, you know, sex with a lot of people. They got into some casual relationships, or they got into some relationship which was completely sexually, you know, motivated, not really motivated with love or any affection. And they knew that even they are addicted to those people. And maybe the relationship is going on because of that one reason, because there's a sexual addiction, you know. So for whatever reason, they were addicted. And now that they're out of the addiction, when they look back at themselves, that person who they were, they realize that had it not been source, they were in a very dark place. So the source always kept, you know, like one, you know, like the intuition was there, or the crown was there, or maybe they were communicating in the dream state. Some of the people in this collective channeling, some of them can go back in time and they can actually think when they were really into the dark world or into the limbo state, but the masters or the higher beings always communicated with them through the dream space. Especially when they were in very bad, very, you know, relationship with very evil, demonic people, the dream state, in the dream state, the answers were given to them, or they were warned that, you know, stay away from this person, or they could hear clear voice messages, or they could just get some kind of a very strong sign or synchronization, and they would know that, you know, they are not in a good place and they need to get out of it ASAP. So all these kind of experiences happened, and now, all these people are saying that, you know, you are settled in my heart, you know, and you are my only desire. You're the only desire I have. The whole day I just don't care about anything else, but I just care about the integration. Even in once in a day, if I feel like I'm with you, I feel the love from you, you know, it's enough for me. I don't want anything more. Even once in a day you do it. So this union that people talk about in the twin flame journey, this union, once you get very deep into your inner work, you know this union can happen every day. Okay. So you are my life, and you're the one who gives peace and love to my soul. You're my happiness. You are everything, you know. And I was away from you. Okay. And I was living a life full of addictions, and I was full of intoxication, the negative or the sick, the side effect laden intoxications that I was in. I was away from you. And when I was really lonely, and when I really needed you, and I was lost, you are the one who held my hand. You are my poetry, you are my music, you are my dance, you are my song, you are my everything, okay? So basically, the same lines again and again, you are the one that gives me peace, you are the one who gives the love to my soul, because what is source integration actually? Source integration is your soul connecting back to its source. Your soul is also made from the same speck of light that source is made from. So understanding that you are a part of the whole, which means you are also like the whole, is such a great feeling, right? So on this note, I'm gonna close this session. Thank you so much for being here with me. One love and peace out.